Thank you for your call to the Centrelink Employment Services line.
A familiar sound for millions of Aussies.
We know you've been trying to reach us and are unable to take your call.
Services Australia admitting that of 41 million calls made in the last financial year, only 31% were answered. July and August this year, even worse. Just 23% of calls answered.
So, I mean, what are you doing about this?
Senator, we think carefully about what we can do to provide a better customer experience.
For those who do get through, an agonising wait.
People are spending 3, 4, 5 hours on a phone call on hold just to try and get through. And they don't hang up because they don't have any other option. You know, if it's not sorted out, they can't just go about their life.
Wait times are increasing despite 18 million fewer calls since last year as pandemic supports continue to be wound back. Services Australia blaming a lack of funding.
Even with that decreased number of calls, your performance on servicing those calls has declined.
When compared to the years that we had pandemic funding, yes and no.
The longest time I've had to wait was just under 2 hours. So you've basically got to block out a couple of hours during your day to really ring them.
Aussies venting their frustration.
Oh my God, 5 hours, 30 minutes on hold, on and off with Centrelink. It was on hold, on and off all day yesterday too.
I did it. I successfully completed the stay on hold to Centrelink for 2 hours challenge.
Imagine spending 2 hours on hold with the powers that be just to get disconnected. I'm so over it.
I just don't call anymore just because the wait times are so long.
Always found them to be a pain, very hard to deal with.
Both sides of politics at fault.
It's absolutely true that both sides of Parliament are to blame for this current crisis. The Coalition created the conditions and the Labor government now has kind of failed to deal with them.
Meanwhile, vulnerable Aussies suffer the consequences.
It was in crisis and now it's on the brink. We need to get funding into that department because vulnerable people need it and they need it done yesterday.
We are experiencing a high number of calls at the moment. Thank you for calling. Goodbye.
It's so frustrating. It's not just the calls, it's the fact that the website is also
it's
almost unnavigable. I was trying to get the childcare subsidies when my kids were little. I couldn't understand it. And I thought, I've got 2 university degrees. How do I not understand this? So I can't imagine the frustration for people who have English as a second language or people who struggle with reading or anything like that. Like, the whole system is designed to deter people from claiming what the government says they're going to give you. That's the whole system.
MyGov is infuriating as a website, isn't it, where you go through that. And the other thing that happens if you call too many times, that the system blocks your number.
You can't call too many times in one day because each time you call, it takes 4 hours.
There we go.
This is true.
Anyway, an update to that story. Liz has 2 university degrees.
Yeah, I know.
We reached out to Services Australia, of course,
for
a statement.
But they, 15.
That's not important. Services Australia didn't respond.
We're left on hold.